Today at DTEK Academy, we will talk with the Ukrainian and international experts about what global changes today can become opportunities for Ukraine. Nataliya, let me ask you from the Ukrainian side. Yeah, what challenges globally do you see from our side here, like not from UK or US? Mm-hmm. They have completely, we may seem completely different problems, but what would you say?
Oh, well, good evening for everyone. Sure, I agree with colleagues that climate change, technology is a big challenge and opportunity at the same time, but we are in Ukraine. We feel acute feel of lack of security. And Ukraine and the world, not only we face the new challenges, new security challenges, as world is changing dramatically and very rapidly. So the type of war changed completely. So now we are not only facing physical security threat as a country, and we are not alone in the world, but we also feel and face, for instance, cybersecurity threat, informational campaign change. So now we face with such as new issue as a deep fake manipulation, when some can, for instance, create panic just using social media spreading deep fakes, and we experienced recently such thing in Ukraine, and it's not the only case in Ukraine. Biological threats. So it was not before, but now we're facing with first big example, and I don't think it's the last one. So the future will be like now. And cyber threats, as you said, economical as well. So, well, the type of war completely changing, and now we should be prepared for different type of threats. And Ukraine here, we are in the forefront of this innovation. Now I'm also taking part in national international security course in Harvard University, and together with senior executive in national security, US national security, I can share a lot of experience being a member of parliament during the last 5 years when we face energy crisis. So energy can also be used as a weapon. And it's a very, very dangerous weapon because, for instance, energy is the base of economy, and you could destroy everything by destroying energy sources. So all these security threats together create a big issue, and we have a good experience. We have feels these threats by our own experience, and we should look for the solution with other countries because it's not local, it's a global issue.
Nataliya, do you agree that the people are already tired of these rapid changes in reforms, and every year we have some news, or we need some more calm time not to, you know, have this all the time changing environment?
Well, when we started from when I came to Parliament in 2014, we faced real big challenges of energy security, so we didn't know whether we survived during the winter and whether it's possible really to supply energy to the population during this turbulent time. So we resolved this issue, we stayed and survived, went through these challenges, and now we are thinking about future of energy, for instance, and different times actually require different solutions. We face new opportunities, new challenges, so, and maybe need new approaches. But what I want to say is that actually all the innovation, they have to be market-driven, so there should be some demand for this innovation. For instance, companies now are looking for cheap types of energy because need of energy transition, because of this climate change issue, it would be tax, it's become absolutely unaffordable, for instance, coal generation. So big companies, they are looking for hydrogen, LNG, these cheaper sources of energy, and it's now the question how to take it to Ukraine. So we already introduced renewables. It's new type of energy. It's the biggest investment since 2014 in renewables in Ukraine, but it's still expensive. But technology is going, price going down, so maybe at some point we'll reach the point when it would be self-sufficient. So people are looking, companies are looking for these things, so they actually trying to find the ways how to get it into Ukraine, because they have a real market need for such innovation and such challenges, to face such challenges. So I suppose we are quite progressive, and not only government, not only parliament, but also companies who are leaders in this sphere, they are institutions, they are looking for such solution. And one more point I want to say is that Ukraine is at forefront of a lot of challenges, and we are important part of European energy security puzzle, about not only energy but also physical security. We are defending democratic values. So here it's a very good place to learn, to have your realization if you are a scientist, if you are a politician, if you like technology guy. So you have to put, you can realize your talent here, because a bigger challenge, big risk, but biggest reward at the same time. So you can invest more, but you can get more because of the opportunity. And for instance, when the country is stable, everything is okay, there is no such a big opportunity and a possibility to realize yourself. So just I support colleagues that we should keep optimist and keep going with our reforms and with our endeavors.